Hello. Today, we're talking about what are cloud economics. Cloud economics is a lot about the pricing of AWS and how that works. There are two main things that we need to be aware of. When you're thinking about pricing with any sort of IT infrastructure, there's two main types to be aware of, CapEx and OpEx. CapEx stands for capital expenditure and is usually a one-time big purchase. So think about setting up something big and new for the first time. It could be something like building a new parking lot or buying printers for the company or setting up your own data center. This is a capital expense, CapEx. This is different to OpEx. OpEx is an operational expense, which is not for an upfront cost, but actually for the ongoing payment of something operationally. Cloud computing very clearly falls under OpEx because it is an operational ongoing cost. We call this the consumption-based pricing model, which essentially means that you just pay for what you use. An integral part of consumption-based pricing is something called rightsizing. Rightsizing means that you are using exactly the right amount of resource for what you need to achieve. Nothing more, nothing less. And you're paying accordingly. Rightsizing is up to you to make sure that you're on top of. So in your setup for AWS, you need to make sure that you're taking these following steps to keep everything in the right size. First, you want to make sure that you're monitoring your usage. You can do this through tools like CloudWatch, which gives you insights into actually how much power and computing and resources you're using. Then you can analyze your data using things like Trusted Advisor or AWS Cost Explorer, where you're looking more for the trends and patterns over time. Then you want to choose the right size. You might find that you've overpaid in some areas, you've got too much. In other areas, you might not have enough resource for actually what you need. Or perhaps you can see a trend that's going up or a trend that's going down, and you can predict in the future we're actually going to need to change the amount of resource that we have. By doing this and taking the time to go through it, you're saving a lot of costs and a lot of money, and you can always come back and adjust them as needed. None of this is here forever, so you can always update or change or move things around as the company or your situations change. Thank you so much for watching. Happy learning. We'll see you next time.